What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Exotic Astrology, and today we'll continue our discussion on the Bhagavad Gita series, where we will discuss about the two characters who are not in the limelight most of the times, but they are very important and they have valuable lessons to teach us, all right? And they are none other than Nakul and Sahadev. Yes, they are the sons of the Ashwini Kumaras through the King Pandu and his second wife Madari. Yes, we all know about that. So if you are new to the channel and you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation, then approach me through my website below. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up. And if you want me to make any other video, then please let me know in the comments. All right. And before I begin, as I always say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and he will be there. Okay. So now, Nakul and Sahadev are not the sons of Kunti. Kunti is the prominent of the two wives which King Pandu had. Kunti's sons' names are Yudhishthir, Bhim and Arjun. And then he had another wife, Madari, through whom he begot Nakul and Sahadev. Yes. But surprisingly, among the Pandavas, among the all the five, Kunti loved Sahadev the most. Although he was not her direct son, he was her stepson officially. Yes. That shows how great Kunti is. Yes. But oh my God, today's video was on Nakul Sahadev. Kunti we will discuss some other time. But Nakul and Sahadev are also extraordinary warriors. They are Maharathis, as the Mahabharata says. They are extremely powerful. They are also invincible like their brothers, Yudhishthir, Arjun and Bhim. But they give us a very, very, very important lesson that although you may be powerful, you may be perfect, but sometimes when there are people better than us, when there are people above us who can do things in a much better way than we can do, yes, it does not mean that we cannot do, but when it means that the other person can do it much better than us, then we should take the humble role and try to follow what they say rather than trying to impose ourselves on them, or rather than trying to compete. Which simply means that although they were great warriors, Nakul and Sahadev, they were as powerful as the other Pandavas, but they knew that when it comes to warfare, Arjuna and Bhima, they were much more strong, they were much more skillful. And when it comes to religion, spirituality, ruling, diplomacy, leadership, Yudhishthir Maharaj was spotless when it came to all those things. Yes. So they decided that let us take a humble role and let us try to be their servants. Yes. Rather than we have the example of Duryodhana, who was also their cousin. Yes. So now see, Duryodhana was the cousin of Yudhishthir. Yes. And Nakul Sahadev were also stepbrothers. So they are not directly their brothers, they are stepbrothers. Yes. And then Duryodhana was the cousin. So in a way, both are far away from Yudhishthir, except Arjuna and Bhima, of course. So Nakul Sahadev are one level far, and then Duryodhana is a bit more far. So they could have also behaved like Duryodhana by trying to hatch schemes using Shakuni, Dushasana and Karna. Yes. By trying to hatch schemes and trying to kill the Pandavas, Nakul and Sahadev also could have done like this. They could have also protested. No. We want to be the king. Nakul will sit there with me. No, Sahadev could have said. And they could have also said that we want half of the kingdom. Yes. Because within the brothers of, within these three, Yudhishthir, Arjun and Bhim, Yudhishthir was the eldest and he was the most qualified. So there was no doubt that Yudhishthir would be the king. So Arjuna and Bhima could have never asked that, oh, we want to be the king. Because that was out of the system, because that's not the way it is to be. The eldest is supposed to be the king, and of course Yudhishthir Maharaj was the most eligible candidate, there was no doubt about that, because of which nobody would by nature obstruct him. Yes, because when there was this Rajasuya Yagya, when Yudhishthir Maharaj wanted to do the Rajasuya Yagya, where every king in the Indian subcontinent that time in the Aryavrat, they had to accept subordination under Yudhishthir Maharaj. Most of the kings voluntarily, the moment they heard Yudhishthir Maharaj is doing Rajasuya Yagya, okay, I submit. Yes, of course there were kings like Jarasandha was there, not everybody surrendered. Then Yudhishthir Maharaj sent Arjun, Bhim, Nakul, Sahadev to four directions to defeat those kings who did not offer their surrender to Yudhishthir Maharaj voluntarily. But still there were many kings who voluntarily submitted themselves to Yudhishthir Maharaj. Yes, they said, oh, Yudhishthir Maharaj is such a great person, we have no problem, our ego is not hurt when we rule under him, because he is known as Ajatshatru, he doesn't have any enemies, he is the best of the best. Yes, one who is calm during war also, that is the meaning of the word Yudhisthira. Yes, so now Duryodhana, who was the cousin of Yudhishthir, he also could have stayed like Nakula and Sahadev. Yes, by being the subordinates of Yudhishthir Maharaj, what would have happened at max, or worst case, what would have happened? I mean, Duryodhana, even if he would have stayed as a subordinate, Yudhishthir Maharaj would have given him everything. Yes, and in fact Yudhishthir Maharaj is so considerate that just because Duryodhana is his cousin, he would have given Duryodhana much more than he would have given his own brothers. Yes, because that's the quality of a great soul, he does more for others than he does for himself. Yes, maybe Yudhishthir Maharaj would have made Duryodhana the head advisor, or maybe the main man in the court, who knows. Yes, or he might have been made the senapati of the army. Yes. So he would have also lived as if he was a king. He would have lived like that. Yes, there would have been no difference, because we are not talking of any ordinary person here. We are talking of Dharmaraj Yudhishthir. He is the crest jewel of all the people who follows religion. Yes, but Duryodhana did not choose this. Duryodhana foolishly thought, oh, I want to kill this person, so I will kill them by burning them in Varnavrat, I will insult their wife, I will try to snatch everything that they have in the gambling match, and then eventually I will kill them. Yes, that's what Duryodhana's plan was. But unfortunately Duryodhana forgot that there was one person in the side of the Pandavas, because of which all the evil schemes which Duryodhana had hatched against the Pandavas were nullified. Who is that person? I will not say. You can write in the comments. Let me see how many of you know who was the person because of which Duryodhana's attempts again and again and again and again were baffled. Yes. So the point here is, Nakul Sahadev could have also behaved like Duryodhana. Yes. They would have also said, no, we don't accept Yudhishthir. No, he's not our brother. He's our stepbrother. We don't accept him. We have different mothers. He could have done that. They could have done it. Why not? But they didn't do that. Yes. And in fact, they were so humble. They were so much subordinate. They were so obedient to Yudhishthir Maharaj that Yudhishthir Maharaj loved Nakul Sahadev more than he loved his own brothers, Arjun and Bhim. Yes. Because when there is an instance when a Yaksha takes the life of all the remaining four Pandavas, in the Mahabharata it comes, then the Yaksha asks to Yudhishthir that, oh Yudhishthir, you have answered my questions. Out of these four, Arjun, Bhim, Nakul, Sahadev, I will give you one person his life back. Whose life do you want? He said, I want the life of Sahadev because he is my mother's favorite. And also the other reason is, from Kunti I am alive, so from Madri one person should be alive. Yes, so Yudhishthir Maharaj loved Nakul Sahadev much more than he loved Arjun and Bhim. Yes, so there was this perfect harmony, perfect cooperation, there was this perfect chemistry, as you say, na, between the authority and the subordinate. and they used to very loyally, faithfully obey whatever Yudhishthira Maharaj said. So the lesson which Nakula and Sahadev is trying to teach us is that we may be very good in something that we are doing, but when we see that there are personalities who are much more qualified, who are much more able, who are much more powerful, who are much more efficient than us, then we should set aside our own ego and let them take the center stage. Yes, and we should try to obey whatever they say, and yeah, whenever asked, we should try to give our opinions. This can be very useful when we work in a team. Yes, in a team, sometimes some of our teammates, they are more intelligent, they are more sharp, they are more smart than us. So then we should not envy them, or we should not be jealous of them. Oh, look, that person is doing more, or that person is getting more. Yes, we should be happy actually that, okay, maybe at least if I am not able to do something, they are able to do. Or even if I am able to do something, they are able to do things in a much more better way than us. Yes, like Arjuna and Bhima were much more powerful than Nakula and Sahadev when it came to military warfare. So this is the lesson which Nakula and Sahadev is telling us. They are trying to teach us by their example, as in the Bhagavatam it is said, Mahajano yena gata sapanta, that we have to learn to walk in the footsteps of the Mahajans. Yes, so then we will realize that we can also be like them. Be like them doesn't mean be exactly like them, but they are like the sun. The great personalities are like the sun, and we can be like the rays which fall into this earth. Yes, so we can also try to be like them, not by imitating them. Yes, we cannot imitate them, they are very great personalities, but we can try to follow in their footsteps. Yes, and whenever we have some senior who is very respectful, very cordial, who is very nice, who is very much able, then we should be very respectful and obedient to them. Yes, so that is what Nakula and Sahadev wants to teach us. Alright, so I hope this video will convey the meanings of what Nakula and Sahadev wants to tell us. Alright, so that is it from my side. We will discuss on other things later. Okay, so if you want a consultation, then please approach me in my website. And if you're new, then please subscribe. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up. And if you want me to make any other video, then please let me know in the comments. Okay, until next time with some other character. Okay, bye bye. See you. We'll be right back.